down towards your heels. Just rest your guard down towards your mat. Please make this comfortable for yourself. Yeah, so if you come into this and it's not comfortable, just readjust your knees. I find bringing the knees in a little bit closer, and that can help support your rib cage. It can be quite nice to take the pressure off your hips. We'll shrug your shoulders. If it feels kind of pinchy through the shoulders, just take them out with your hands out a little wider. Yeah? And really allow the weight of your forehead just to rest down into the mat. Maybe even just rock it from side to side. And start to slow yourself down. So take some steady breaths in and out of your nose. And see if you can breathe all the way down into the pit of your belly. So as you take an inhale breath, the diaphragm, that main part of the main muscle that you use to breathe, draws down. Your belly will inflate, the side ribs will inflate. And then as you exhale, you feel everything drawing back in to press the air up and out of your lungs. Yeah. And just take 8 rounds of breath at your own pace, in your own time. Rush with your breathing, just in time with yourself, where you have different sized human beings and we have different sized lungs. We use different capacities of our lungs, so please, in time with yourself, don't get too stuck up in your head about it. You may find as you start to bring your awareness to the breath, you notice how flying the nature of your mind is, it gets distracted by things around you. Whenever you find yourself getting distracted, and it's not an if, it's a when, right? When you find yourself distracted, bringing the attention back to your breath. Movement of air in and out of your nose. Okay, I'll take one more round of breath. Allow yourself to stay for the entire exhale, so lungs completely empty, and then make your way up onto your hands and knees. So you come into a full point position. So hands underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, and we'll move through your head, cow. So follow an inhale breath to draw the belly down, to lift the hips up, to broaden through your chest, perhaps start to look up towards the ceiling. And exhale, curl the other way, tailbone tucks down, jaw draws in towards your chest, and see if you can start looking up towards your belly line. Inhale, belly drops. Gaze high. Exhale, curl back in towards yourself, and just keep on moving like that as you move in between these two shapes, and it's led by your breath. See if you can move one little bone of your spine after the other. It's like a little chain reaction of movements, perhaps start it from the tailbone, and then go all the way up towards the crown of your head. Do that a couple times. And then take it back the other way, starting from the crown of your head and all the way back towards your tailbone. And you'll find that one way feels better than the other, or easier than the other. Yeah? For me, taking the movement from my head all the way down to my tailbone feels really clunky. It feels like I'm moving just like two pieces. Yeah. So if you slow it down, find a little bit more mobility, more isolation in that movement. Let's take one more of those. Finishing up with the exhale, the curl up nice and high, and return just to a neutral spine. So come to a flat back. Plant the left hand down, spread your fingertips out nice and wide. And on your inhale, reach your right arm up towards the ceiling. See if you can broaden your chest towards the right. And then exhale, put the right arm underneath your left. So your right shoulder, your right cheek comes down towards the ground. And then you can keep the left hand where it is. Just start to nudge your right shoulder a little bit further underneath you. And then we'll get a little bit of a stretch from your left hand side as well. So keep on pulling the left hip bone back behind you. Start to walk your left fingers towards the front arm. And just do the left side stretch. Yeah. Couple deep rounds of breath. Just notice how at different points of the breath, the intensity of the stretch feels different. Just get a little curious about it. And then on your next exhale, walk the left fingers back and towards you, and you come out the same way you came in. So follow an inhale, stretch your right arm up towards the ceiling. And exhale, right hand comes down. And you soft the sides. Left arm spreads up towards the ceiling. Inhale, see if you can lengthen out the two arms. Exhale, left arm underneath your right, left shoulder, left cheek comes down. And you can even press down into the right palm to really start drawing the right shoulder and the shoulder blade back behind you. as you just shift the left shoulder underneath. Allow yourself to land here, and then add the right hand side in. Start to let the right fingertips close and pull your right hip crease back. Take some deep breaths into your right side ribs. See if you can just feel your way into it. One more round of breath. Inhale. Exhale to empty. Right hand comes back in. Left arm sweeps up. Inhale. Exhale. Left hand comes down towards the ground. This is Abby's favorite shape. Hands underneath your shoulders. Toes tucked. Now make your spine nice and long. You're really just like really just lengthen yourself out. Now lift your lower belly. Switch your core on. Switch your legs on. Remember to breathe normally. All I want you to do is just lift your knees just a little bit up above the mat, like half a centimeter. So you'll find, if you lift your knees up super high, this is going to be quite easy. The lower you get the knees, the harder it's going to be. And notice how you start to get a little bit kind of arm and shoulder dominant and kind of start to round here. Instead, lengthen yourself out again, lift your lower belly, take a deep breath in. Slow breath out, steady your gaze. How long are we going to stay here? I don't know. Take a deep breath in. And exhale, shift your weight back. Downward facing dog. Just as about lengthening out the legs, you can leave as much of a bend in your knees as you like. And just pedal out through your heels. So press one down as you reach the other one up. And swap the sides over. Yeah. Maybe just palm out the hands. Keep on pedaling out the feet. Start to like stretch yourself out here. Shrug the shoulders, jiggle your head, to start to find yourself a comfy variation of this shape. And it's pretty similar to your child's pose in regards that you can take your hands out wide if the shoulders feel sticky. Yeah? You can bend your knees if the hamstrings feel tight, shrug your shoulders, if everything feels tight, just take a slow and steady round of breath, we're not going to be here forever. Inhale, come onto the balls of your feet, come nice and high. Soften your knees some more, and then just start casually walking your feet towards the top of your mat, one foot after the other, until your feet just end up behind your wrists, right? Give yourself a good amount of space in between the two feet. Take a halfway lift, bend your knees, flatten out your back, and start drawing your shoulders back out of your ears. And exhale back and towards yourself. And be kind to yourself here, please bend your knees, and then cross your arms in front of your chin. See if you can dump the crown of your head down towards the ground so your gaze comes back behind you. So if you're staring lovingly down at your feet, it means that you've kicked up through the back of your neck. Send the gaze back behind you. Nice. And take a little sway from side to side. So right to left, left to right. You can pop a little bit of a bounce into it. That feels quite nice, yeah? Maybe it's quickly or slow, like whatever goes. Whatever feels good. Untangle your arms. Allow them to hang nice and heavy down towards the ground. Toe through your feet just a little bit close together and roll yourself up to stand. So follow an inhale and start to climb bone by bone up through the spine. Move nice and slow. There is absolutely no hurry. The last thing to come up is your shoulders and your head. Inhale, stretch the arms out wide. Look up towards the sky. Exhale, hands come down through prayer and heart center. Close your eyes. Take a little rock forwards and backwards. And side to side, get nice and balanced in between the two feet. Ground down through the four corners of each feet, so your big toe and your little toe, and inside and the outside of your hips. Release your hands down towards the ground. And let's begin. Inhale, reach your arms out wide, and crack your eyes open, look up towards the ceiling. Exhale, bow back down towards yourself. And forward fold, soften your knees, bump the crown of your head down. On your inhale, take a halfway lift. So send your tailbone back, put your chest forward. And exhale, fold back in towards yourself. We'll do that again. Inhale, half lift. Exhale, your hands come flat. Now spread your fingertips out wide, ground them into the mat, set your feet. When you land here in your plank, send your heels back and pull your chest forwards. Lift the lower belly and draw your inner thighs up towards the ceiling. Give yourself a moment. A moment, yep. And then take your knees down towards the ground. Lower slow, draw your elbows into the side ribs. Take a little shift forward. Press into the top of your feet. Inhale, cobra pose. So feel your chest, pull forward, your shoulders lift up. And I know it's so tempting to use your arms and your legs. Yes! No! Come back down, use your core. The hands can actually lift up off the mat as you lift your chest up. Yeah. Place your hands back down. Exhale, shift the back, child's pose. Snuggle the hips towards the heels, the hands towards the front of the knee forwards. Breathing down to the breath. But can you make this child's pose a little bit more active than the first one? So press your hands deeply down into the mat and start lifting your forearms and your elbows up away from it. Yeah. Then send your hands forward and draw your shoulders down the back. So it feels like your arms are stretching out super long. Take one more inhale. Exhale, shift your back, downward facing dog. So you lift your butt up. And then take a back fall behind you, downward face. Deep breath in. Slow breath out. Inhale, come onto the balls of your feet. Soften your knees. And then exhale, you can walk or step your feet towards the top of your mat. Halfway lift, inhale, your chest forward. Exhale, out back down and towards yourself. Inhale, the arms to belt wide, lift yourself to stand. Hands above your head, feet press back down. Exhale, bow straight back and towards yourself. So you keep your hinge from your hips. Inhale, halfway, draw your chest forward. Exhale, hands come flat, step your feet back, plank pose. We're going to sink our knees down towards the ground again. Now, how smoothly can you lower yourself down? High plank to low plank, squeeze your elbows in. And keep them tucking in, press into the top of your feet, lightness into your hands as you inhale, cobra. Exhale, lift it back down and shift it back, downward face. And you can either move through child's pose or you can come back up through plank. Whatever suits. And we meet back, downward facing dog. Take another three rounds of breath here. And then follow that with one round of just your namaskar and the same thing. Steady your breath, steady your gaze. Last time. Inhale, hop onto your toes. Soften your knees, look forward. You can walk, step, or take a little hop to the top of your mat. Halfway lift. Inhale, draw the chest forward. Exhale, bow back in towards yourself and follow your inhale, sweep up to stand. You follow your exhale, bow straight back down and towards yourself, standing forward fold. Inhale, halfway lift, draw your chest forward. Exhale, hands flat, feet step. You can place your knees down to the ground if you'd like to keep this nice and straight. Take a little shift forward and then lower down halfway. So you don't want your shoulders to go any lower than your elbows. Yeah, squeeze your elbows in. On your inhale, either your cobra or your upward face. If you're in upward face, lift the thighs and the hips up as you press down into the hands. Exhale, take it back, downward facing dog. Now, as you settle in here, I'd really like you to try and use your legs more than your arms. I know it's super tempting to get upper body dog in here. So spread your fingertips out, right? Press the hands down. Shift more weight back into your feet. That means bending your knees even more, taking a tiny little step forward to make that actually doable. And go for it. There's no point in working too hard, right? And remember to breathe, because I can hear when you're not breathing. It's an echoey room. It's hard not to hear when you're not breathing. Breathing in yoga, that's a good idea. Alright, let's find our flow for this morning. Take a deep breath in, reach your right leg up towards the ceiling. Nice and slow, super steady. Then exhale, squeeze your knee in towards your nose. So shift your shoulders forward so you can bend the wrists. Can you just lift your right leg? Closer in towards yourself. And just notice how your right hand might be hanging a little low. Lift that up to yeah. And take a step through. Turn your left foot out about 45 degrees and come on up for warrior one. So stretch your arms out wide. Now I find often when you come into the shape, the feet are really close together. So you might start to toe heel out just a little bit wider so the space that you're just your feet, so left toes now point towards the left hand side of the room. Nice. Right toes where they are. Stretch the arms out long. Then just drop your shoulders down again. Can you feel your shoulder blades start to squeeze in towards your spine? Yeah. And you broaden through your chest. Can you lift the crown of your head up a little taller? But drop your shoulders down. Yeah. It takes a little bit of time to do that. On your inhale, flip into palms, reach your arms up towards the ceiling as you lengthen your right leg, gaze high. Exhale, roll back down, warrior two. Do that with the breath. Inhale, arms lift, right leg lengthens, gaze high. Exhale, lower down. One more time, same thing again. If you like, you can lift your right toe towards the ceiling so you come onto your heel as you do it. Watch out if you're wearing socks. Yeah, exhale, come back down. Keep the lower body as it is. Just right palm, inhale, reverse your warrior. So right hand comes high, left hand slides down your left leg. And exhale, move both of your hands down towards the ground. Come onto the ball of the left foot. Now plug your hands down, lengthen your arms. Lift up through your shoulders so you're not hanging out the bottom of your shoulder. You're lifting up. So you can pick up your right foot and thread it back without dragging it. Yeah. Knees can come down to the ground, roll up slow, high plank to low plank. Inhale, cobra or upward face, whichever speed you want. Yeah. Exhale, lower back down, shift the back, downward facing dog. Take a moment here to breathe. Both hands, both feet, lower down into the mat. And we'll do the other side. Inhale, left leg lifts up towards the ceiling. Squeeze your knee in towards your nose, and when I say knee towards the nose, I mean quite literally. Up and towards your nose, lift the heel as well, and take a nice long step. Sometimes it's not one step, but like three or four steps, totally fine. Turn your right toes out and down, square your hips towards the front row, and you lift yourself up. Warrior one. Just take a moment just to adjust it in this side as well, because both sides aren't even. Yeah, one side, calf muscle might be tighter, right hip flexor might be tighter, so you just like readjust. Figure it out, yeah? Doesn't need to be perfect, this is going to be interesting. And then when you're ready, you steady your gaze. You take one round of breath. And empty it out. Inhale to fill up. Exhale to open out, warrior two. So personally, I like to walk my left foot in a little closer with my right toes turn out and down. Squeeze both your legs in towards the midline as you stretch your arms out a little bit longer. Take a deep breath. Exhale, maybe go a little bit deeper into your left leg. We move through our pulses, so flick your two palms. Inhale, lengthen left leg, look up towards the ceiling. And then exhale, lower back down nice and slow. Inhale, both legs along. Exhale, lower yourself down. Third time's a charm. Inhale. Exhale, lower yourself down. Flip the front palm, reverse your warrior. Inhale, take it up and back. Lift your gaze. Exhale, both hands move down to the mat. Plug the hands, step your left foot back. We'll do the same thing again. We'll stop one more time. So, steady with the breath. Inhale, reach your right leg up towards the ceiling. Exhale, tie your curl, draw your knee towards your nose. Step, warrior one. Inhale, reach your arms out wide. Exhale, warrior two. Now, one pulse. Inhale, arms along, right leg is long. Exhale, lower yourself back down. Reverse your warrior. Inhale, right hand comes up. Exhale, we move your hands down towards the ground. Onto the ball, left foot without a sound. Pick up your right foot, try not to drag it. If you'd like more intensity, the right foot flows as you lower high plank to low plank. Cobra or upward facing dog, your choice. Do it your way. Exhale, take it back, downward facing. make sure you can see your toes. If you can't see your toes, I know it's super counterintuitive, but you need to lean back, press down into the heels. And then when you look at your toes, if they're kind of just like hanging on for dear life, pick them up, spread them out. Relax your toes, yeah. Because I promise you, like, the muscles in your toes, they're so small. They're not going to help you. Like, I think it's really cute that they've shown up to the party and they're like, oh, I'm going to do this, I'm going to help. And they're not helpful. Yeah. Deep breath. Exhale, bring your hands down through your heart center. You're not going to like me. Inhale, lift your chest. Exhale, twist to the, what is that, your left. Yeah. Yes, left. Cool. Pull your right elbow over the left thigh. Press the two palms. Now sink from your bum lower and lift your chest higher. Because often what happens here, because that's what we twist, the butt gets high, the head goes low, and you're like, yeah, all day. Not quite. Sink your bum, lift your chest. Inhale, come back up through center. Exhale, twist to the right. Yes. Hook your elbow. Press the two palms up, lift your chest, and think about getting that middle part of your sternum towards your thumbs. Can you send your left rib cage underneath you as you shift your right shoulder to the back? Yes. My legs are on fire. How about you guys?
Cool.
Yeah, good. Break. Inhale, come back up. Chair. Interlace your hands behind your back. And then exhale, bow towards yourself. Lengthen your arms. Release your head. Give a little jiggle. Yeah. Shrug your shoulders. Now, chances are that when you interlace your hands behind your back, they kind of pull apart. See if you can get your hands right down towards your bum and start to bring the heads, not the heads, the heels of your hands together. So, like these meatheads here, draw them together. Because often what happens is we go like that because we have tight shoulders. Try and bring them together. Then draw your knuckles away from you. Shrug your shoulders. Yeah. That's a paddling, isn't it? Yeah. You got it. Yep. Just nice and long. You're like, Nikki, then don't go long. Yeah, that's okay. Yeah, you got it. Yeah. Drop the crown of your head down towards the ground. Now, I recommend bending your knees a little bit. Yeah. Make this less intense in your hamstrings. Allow yourself to rinse out your shoulders. Take a deep breath. And then exhale, release. The hands come down towards the ground. You bend your knees, you keep the arms up, you sink your hips. Just one more shot. One more of these. Yes. Deep breath. Exhale, back in towards yourself. We'll meet for a halfway lift. So inhale. Exhale, your hands come back flat. Your feet sit back. And you can either move through Vinyasa, take it straight back to child's pose, or the downward facing dog. And we need back downward facing dog. Now the rest comes really soon. Alright, inhale, ripple yourself forward into your high plank. Take your forearms down to the ground. And bring your elbows underneath your shoulders and the hands in line with your elbows. There. Put yourself forward a little bit. And take it back. Pulse. Back nose to get really sinky through the shoulders. Lift yourself up. Lift the lower belly for three. Remember to breathe. Sit two. For one, lower yourself down. This is your rest. Take your feet out a little wider. Press into the top of your feet. Press down into your forearms and lift your chest. And relax your shoulders. Maybe close your eyes. And breathe. Now, if you do have quite a noodly spine and you do like a deeper back bend, I'm not saying it's better, I'm just saying it's more intense. If you're not feeling anything, absolutely, you can come into the field. release your forearms.
Yeah.
We're going to start walking the hands further away from each other. Breath the two palms, squeeze them in towards the midline. This is the last little bit of core we're going to do. Tuck your toes, lengthen your spine, and you lift yourself up. And we'll just take three rounds of breath. It's really hard, right? I feel really intense, but what the fuck is this?
Yeah?
We've got to count the two, length for one. Lower yourself down, release the arms.
Yeah.
Little wiggle from side to side. Release that. Unfortunately, that wasn't asymmetrical shape, so we gotta do both sides. You do it the other way. Take your left fingertips towards your right elbow. Take your right elbow, fingertips towards your left elbow. Cool. Walk your hands out about the same distance again. This is the opposite way, isn't it?
Yes.
Good. Okay, perfect. Tuck your toes underneath you. Now, maybe even before you come up into this one, recruit your core, right? So feel your lower belly drawing up and towards your spine. Yeah, feel it wrap all the way around the back of it as well.
Yeah.
And then nice and calm, taking your breath with you. Inhale. Exhale, lift yourself up. And just stay here. Just the three rounds of breath, slow and steady. And please don't hyperventilate yourself out of this one. Like, I'll just breathe really quick and then come out. No, we'll stay. Yeah. The two. For one, come all the way on down. Now, thread your arms all the way to lie flat. You just take one cheek down from that. Make a little wagging your hips again. I'm not going to make you guys get up again, so you just get nice and comfy down here, right? Now we're going to start our next shape by just leaving the left arm exactly as it is. Bend up your right elbow, take it up towards the ceiling, and take your hand underneath your elbow. Like that on the other side. Yeah, perfect. Now, use that right hand and you will start rolling yourself on towards your left shoulder and your left hip. Pick up your right knee, and you can just drip your toes back behind you. Yeah. Now, the more you press into your right hand, the more you stack your right side onto your left side, the stronger it's going to be. Yeah, you're just really bending, Pete. You're like, is this right? Yeah, you got it right. You're just sloppy. Yeah. Just let your head come down to the mat. Yeah, perfect. Alright, I'm just gonna come back onto your belly. Yeah. Just feel nice for yourself. There you go. You got that. Yeah. And now just get into your chest, get into your pec. Oh, stay really good. Four rounds of breath here. In my opinion, this shape's an absolute winner. You can also do it up against a wall. One more round of breath. You just really smooth it out. So it's not like a sharp inhale, a hold, and a full exhale. Just slow and steady. Easy, calm, easy go. And we're just going to tweak it a little bit. So roll back onto your belly. We're going to do the same thing with our right hand back and just keep on doing what it's doing. But this time, just make a nice, like, 90-degree angle with your left arm. Yeah. Cool. Now, as best as possible, keep your left shoulder down onto the mat. Turn your right cheek, sorry, your left cheek, and then roll yourself onto your left hand side again. Breathe. 5 deep rounds of breath. I don't know about you guys, but I find this one significantly less comfortable. Gets more into your delt, which is that like top muscle right on the top of your shoulder, like that little cap. Yeah. Notice if your mind is able and just is, you know, gone someplace else. Bring it back with your breath. And on your next exhale, you can lower yourself back down. But real slow, like you're not excited about coming out of it. Just like piece by piece. Magic out. And we'll just swap the sides over when you're ready. So if you need some time in between the two, absolutely give yourself time to rebound. Just release the left arm. and then up the left arm. So it's like a little kind of get going leg, yeah? When you're ready, allow your right shoulder and your right cheek just to be spaced with the head and start shifting towards the right. And that means it's only really gentle, and that's what it is, yeah? Maybe you have quite a lot of space. If that's the case, I should have said this on the first side. Then you can just keep on going, keep on shifting onto the left hand side. So the right hand side to the point where you can then bend up your right foot. And the arm comes back behind you. Yeah? Maybe. It's not better, it just means I have floppy shoulders in that general direction, right? The more you allow yourself to relax into these shapes, the more you're going to get out of them. So going hard isn't going to get you more. Go steady, go nice and slow, go easy, and that's what's going to help you create flexibility. Last round of breath. And release, come back onto your belly. Just make that really subtle adjustment. All you're going to do is just bend the right forearm, point your fingers towards the front of the room. Once you've found it, then you shift your way back. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So it's a good point to say that if a funny little noise escapes you as you're coming out, you're like, yep, yeah, that's it. It's also really nice to see in this shape. I'm going to come up and you guys stay. There is a huge difference in the shape between your dominant side and your non-dominant side. Yeah. If you're ever doing this shape on your own, I'd highly recommend stay for a little longer on the tight side and by yourself just to marinate there a little bit longer. Maybe even just do a tiny bit less. Now, if you're working really hard, do less, make it more comfy. You don't need to punish yourself. Last time, breath. And then make your way back out, roll to your belly. And just make any shape that feels good. Arms can stretch forward, you can put a little pillow over your forehead, arms back, like whatever goes. Give yourself a moment, give your shoulders a little rest. And like I said, I'm not going to make you guys get back up, so let's just roll over onto our backs. It doesn't matter which way your feet are pointing. Don't get too bent out of shape, dad. Just roll yourself over. And we're going to start winding it back down. So allow your upper body, you're not super heavy on the mat. Bend up your knees, walk the feet in. Leave the left foot where it is and stretch your right leg up towards the ceiling. Bend your right knee, place the right foot on top of the left knee, yeah? Now flex your right foot, start drawing your toes towards your right knee, yeah? Press your heel away, just so you can wake up the right leg. And then interlace your hands behind your left leg, start drawing that in towards yourself. Nice. So allow yourself to stay. Breathe. Fell into the soothing sound of the floor downstairs. Yes.
Soothing.
There's always going to be something. One of my housemates used to say, I'll be calm when everything around me is calm. I'm like, oh, that's never going to happen to you. Never going to happen. You're waiting for your external situation to be calm so you can be calm. You're going to be waiting a really long time. So regardless of like what you've got going on around you, neighbors, kids, cars, whatever it is, there's always something. Instead of sending your awareness outwards, can you turn it back in? Do you feel like another good squeeze? And then you can release it. Take the right foot back down towards the ground. And then draw your with your eyes, allow them to shut down. And inhale, make your way back through the center. Drop your knees to the left. Take your gaze to the right. Gently release it. Yeah. Slow and steady. When you take the other side, so you scoot your hips to the left. Walk your feet over towards the right. Take your arms up and over your head towards the right as well. And settle on it. Any little adjustments you want to make on this side, go for it. Anything you've done with that side. When you feel like both sides are nice and balanced out, you can release and make your way back through. So, in your own time. And all you're going to do is just shuffle back in towards the midline and make your way towards your final resting pose. So, your feet come out nice and wide, toes way out. The arms come down by the sides. Arms face up. Do as much wiggling around as you need to get nice and comfortable. Any layers or anything to make yourself more comfortable to do it. Because of the nature of the internet, you can just stay here as long as you like. Yeah. Now, if you can't hear me, it's because I'm not talking or your internet is frozen. Either way, allow yourself just to stick with breathe. And if your mind wants to wander, let it wander. Allow yourself to release any manipulation that you have in your breath so it casually just comes and goes. We just use this time now just to integrate the effects of our practice into the movement and slowly back in. Relief from your dips. And then your toes. Stretch your arms up and over your head. Press out the balls of your feet. So you just stretch yourself out just like nice and long.
Full body yawn, maybe natural yawn.
Little sigh as you wiggle yourself around. Draw your knees up and towards your chest, wrap your arms around your shins, and maybe even bring your nose right up and towards your knees. Roll into a little ball on your right hand side. And then make your way up into a comfortable seated position. Legs can cross, or legs can tuck underneath you, whatever you prefer. Bring your hands into prayer in front of your chest. That's all. Close your eyes. Thank yourself for showing up and doing your practice. And even if you feel like it's difficult or didn't go how you wanted it to, that doesn't matter. Take a deep breath in through your nose. Exhale through your mouth. Bowing forwards in neutral.